So, you are an artist, and you worry about style a lot.
Well, relax, because I'm about to reveal to you the formula to finding your own style.
And you know it's legit, because you're going to use math.
Math?
Yes, math. Hear me out. After years and years of scientific research, I'm finally able to reveal to you the formula to discover your style. Allow me to explain. X here stands for style, since that's what we're trying to figure out. Now let's look at the actions you need to take to get there. T is for time. You'll notice this one come up a lot. So if you're not a patient person, actually, it doesn't matter. Whether you like it or not, you have to put in the time. S in here represents skill. Notice that we multiply skill by time, which means you will need solid amounts of those. Skill itself can be represented by a simple multiplication. So let's have a look at that. Skill is the result of time and practice. There are some scholars who believe in a mysterious unicorn coefficient, which they argue also plays a role here. I personally am of a different school of thought, which doesn't recognize this. But for the sake of coherence, I'd mention it for you. Some call it talent, others call it gift. Whether you believe in it or not, however, is irrelevant since research shows that its influence is negligible. Even if you support its existence, there's no need to worry about it since we can't influence it in any way. We can't create or destroy it. Okay, let's move on. Next, we have M, which stands for medium. Now this one isn't as influential as the first two, but certainly plays a role. Your medium or mediums of choice are sure to influence your style. Are you a digital artist or traditional? Do you paint with watercolor or acrylic or pastels? Each medium has its own advantages and limitations, and they're sure to give your style a certain unique texture. Next, after we took our time, sharpen our skills, and master our tools, we are going to divide the result by I, which stands for influences. This one is really important. Let's first clarify what we mean by influences. Here we consider every single thing that might have any effect on you. The artists and art movements that you enjoy, your inspirations, the films you watch, the music you love, the books that you read, and so on. A mistake many make is to give those influences way too much power and let them define you. This is where math comes in. These people multiply their score so far rather than divide it by their influences. Well, it's impossible to isolate yourself from external factors, and you certainly shouldn't. You should keep them in check and not let them be your only guide, or your work will end up lazy and derivative without its own voice. Okay, we're almost done. Once you figure out your score so far, you should add your P variable, and that is your personality. All your values, beliefs and quirks, your history, your experiences, the lessons you've learned, the ideas you've developed, these will also be multiplied by time. So the longer you've been doing this, the higher your score. All this should be present in your style, and if you've been ignoring this part of the equation, it's time you add it to the rest. Looks good. Seems about done, doesn't it? Well, not quite. The second most common mistake people make when trying to figure out their style is to stop there and call it a day. Now, this won't be terrible, as it should still help you arrive at a very satisfying result, but you might find yourself a bit lost if you forget the last part. There's one last variable which will help you make your style razor sharp. We'll call that last variable G, or goals. Without the hashtag. And we'll take our result so far and raise it to the power of G. This is probably the hardest one to define, especially when you don't know what you want, or you want way too many different things that seem incompatible with each other. I can totally relate. But listen, take your time to get to know yourself and what really turns you on, professionally speaking. When you figure that out, focus all your efforts around that, up a strategy for getting there. And your style should obviously reflect that. If you follow this formula and perform all the actions in the correct order, you should arrive at a style which is not only deeply personal and connected to you, but perfectly suited for the work you wish to do in the future. To be honest with you, you will probably never arrive at a place where your style becomes a constant. It will forever change and evolve with you, but there will probably be notable
milestones on the way. Don't panic, don't rush, don't force anything. Remember, the one constant we keep seeing through this equation is time. So let it work for you. And in the meantime, you do your work. Remember to let me know how it goes. If this was helpful to you, please let me know by liking, subscribing and commenting. You're also more than welcome to stalk me all over the social media, but mostly Instagram, I guess. I'm also trying to figure out Twitter, if that's your kind of thing. It's also fine to do absolutely nothing. Regardless, I'll see you next time, and until then, have fun!